behalf of the Dean and Chapter, I'd like to welcome you to the fourth concert of the Abbey's 2015 summer season for brass bands. Today we give a very warm welcome back to Barclay Brass, Barclay Bank's very own brass band. The band has been in existence for over 30 years, playing to audiences all over the country. It's made up of staff and retired staff from as far south as Poole to Manchester in the north, not forgetting Bristol in the west and Newmarket in the east. The players get together to support charities as well as staff and bank events throughout the year. Before they begin, just one or two practical notices. The first is, if you are in need of loos, they are situated to my left, just behind the buildings there. And please just follow the directions. If you come without lunch, do please feel free to check out the range of refreshments on sale by the tree on the other side of the park. We have a wide variety of snacks and drinks available for you to purchase. Close to the refreshment table, we have a donations point where you can pick up a copy of today's programme. And so without further ado, I shall hand over to the band's conductor today, Mr. David Hewell, who will introduce the first item, Jubilee March, by Bertrand Brett. Ladies and gentlemen, Barclay Brass.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Can you all hear me?
Yes.
Excellent. As the Gavin said, we are Barclay Brass. We are generally made up of bank staff and tech staff. One or two holidays makes us bring in the odd player, and I'll introduce a couple of those a little later on. You've got a printed programme, I know, and someone came up to me earlier and said, you're not playing all of this, are you? We'll be here till tea time. We've got to be finished by two, so we've either got to play them all very quickly. But what that was a programme we submitted a couple of months ago saying it will be from these pieces. So I think all the pieces we're playing are on that list, but they're not necessarily, well, not necessarily, not definitely not doing all 30. So, got a coast to catch it too. So we'll be doing a first half of a quick 10-minute break, and then we've got to finish by 2 o'clock. You can't miss it. There's a great big clock there that will tell us when it's 2 o'clock, and when that goes off, we've got to be done. It's lovely to see so many people here. I always think this is going to be mainly tourists, but I see a few old faces and hopefully friendly faces who we've seen here many times before. All very, very welcome. Hope you're going to enjoy it. First march was march called Jubilee by Paul Dury, and it's a Salvation Army march written in 1998, and it takes three songs from the Salvation Army and turns it really into a circus march, hence the speed of the thing. We're going to continue now with the first of two numbers that really celebrate the life of Frank Sinatra. Frank Sinatra would have been 100 this year, and so we're going to pay our tribute by two numbers. The first one is something called Swing When You're Winning, which I'm sure some of you have got the album that Robbie Williams did. It really is his homage to the great American songbook, and particularly Frank Sinatra, in about 2001. And this is our version of Swing When You're Winning. Thank you. mentioned we're going to play two pieces for tonight. We are going to follow it on. It's a little strange because you've just heard a half a strain of it in the last piece. But I wanted to introduce really one of our guests. It's actually a duet we're going to play now, and features someone. If you're in brass band, someone rather famous. There he is. If you're not in brass bands, you'll think, who is he? But, I'm going to keep talking, I think, they can't find the music. It's all on one copy, so... The lady being a bit shy is Leslie. She's ex-Barclays and she plays for Havant Band in Leicestershire. And the other guy, say if you know anything about brass bands, that's David Hurst. What, the David Hurst? Yes, it's the David Hurst, ex-Black Dyke. Wonderful player, conductor, trainer, adjudicator, all-round goody two-shoes, really, but great guy, great player, and a great friend. And so we thought, well, if we're going to have somebody like that here, we might as well feature him. So, again, going back to the Frank Sinatra thing, this is an arrangement of Something Stupid. You heard a little bit snippet of it. This is the full version. So, Something Stupid, Leslie, David.
Thank you.
earlier that we are perhaps going to get a little shower. There was one as we arrived here and we were unloading our coach. Come on, if we get a shower, don't worry, we're going into that tent. I just didn't want you worrying what would happen to us. If it does happen, you're going to get wet and we'll be out as soon as it stops again. Okay? We did have the option of playing at St Margaret's Church, but by the time we've got there, it'll be time to go. So we'll disappear into the air. See you in 5 minutes. Okay? But hopefully, fingers crossed, it won't happen. I'm going to play a piece now, which I'm told by my bird-watching friends is an impossibility. It's called, I thought we'd play something London, and it's called A Nightingale Sang in Barclay Square. And they said if ever one did, they would be very surprised. So, Nightingale Sang in Barclay Square.
Thank you.
you'll have guessed by now that brass bands are not really that fussy where we get our music from. We'll steal anything, providing it works as an arrangement for bands. Which is just to say that Shostakovich is rarely done with brass bands. We did it here last year, and I liked it, and I'm now doing it with my band, and it's a great little number, this. Shostakovich said there's not a great deal transcribed for brass band, but this seems to work. I like it, hope you do too. It's his second waltz.
Thank you.
Salvation Army for our next piece of quiet, appropriate at the minute. It's called Mid All the Traffic. And it's an arrangement by Captain Leonard Valentine of the... So I don't see many of those where are they? In the Salvation Army, and he took John Oxenham's words to Mid All the Traffic of the Ways, took the tune, the very well-known folk tune of Shenandoah, and put the two together, and it's turned out into a beautiful arrangement. Hope you'll like it, called Mid All the Traffic. The piece about Prohibition era Chicago is probably not the piece to play in a beautiful setting such as this, but we're going to do it anyway. It's from a show called Chicago, which was originally stage show in 1975 and turned, I think, 2002 into a film. Most of the stories are the same, but some of the songs were changed between stage and film. But one of the ones that remained in both has probably become the most famous song from it. And we're going to play it for you now. Cracking little arrangement of And All That Jazz. So you didn't realise you got a choir as well, did you? That's it, that's the end, that's the vocals over from the band, thankfully. We're going to have a 5 minute break in about 5 minutes. We're going to play one more piece and then we're just going to have a quick break and then we should be back. So unless it rains, then we should be in the tent. But we're going to play a piece now by a name synonymous really with brass bands, a guy called Eric Ball. He was a great man for brass bands, with arrangements, compositions for secular bands, for Salvation Army bands, for contest pieces, you name it, and Eric Ball has done music that covers the occasion. Great man, great composer, and a great, really, advocate of brass bands. This is his arrangement of a Swedish tune, which I didn't realise until fairly recently. It's called How Great Thou Art, and it was voted the number one hymn by Songs of Praise did about 10 years ago. This came out at number one, and it's a wonderful arrangement, and really more in setting with the occasion than in Chicago in the Prohibition era. So remembering where we are, we're going to play a lovely arrangement of How Great Thou Art.